Diegene wat die nuus volg sal weet, daar is groot spanning tussen verskeie bendes en fakties wat met die sogenaamde onderwêreld in Kaapstad verbind word. Dit het selfs al na ander dele van die land versprei. So was daar vanjaar reeds minstens 10 sluipmoordaanvalle in Johannesburg wat glo direk te doen het met georganiseerde misdaad. Ons begin vanaand se program met een verslag van Romain Tabota. Sy het met een van Suid-Afrikaanse voorste ondersoekende journaliste gaan gesels om te hoor wat aan die gebeur is. Baie welkom en kom ons kyk.
Die onlangse moord op 'n prominente advokaat in Kaapstad dui nie net op hoe georganiseerde misdaad floreer nie, dit dui ook op hoe ingewikkeld die ondergrondse netwerk is. Dit sluit mense van alle beroepe, klasse en agtergrond in.
Die Tsjechiese maffiabaas Radovan Krejcer was berig vir die skrikbewind wat hy gevoer het terwyl hy in Bedford View gewoon het. Deesdae word daar amper daagliks berig oor ander beweerde bendebase soos Jerome Donkie Boysen, Mark Liffman en Hafiz Modak in Kaapstad. Die joernalis en skrywer Mandy Wiene het reeds verskeie boeke oor die onderwerp geskryf, die mees onlangse daarvan, die topverkoper Ministry of Crime in Underworld Explored.
There is this concept that we speak about called the underworld, which is very difficult to define because there isn't really a technical definition of it. There is one of organized crime. And I suppose the underworld we're speaking about here is around nightclub security. Often it involves Eastern Europeans and the drug trade. But there's lots of different underworlds that operate in parallel to one another, but are all interconnected. So there's abalone poaching underworld. There's illegal cigarette trafficking underworld. The Chinese triads or Nigerian cartels. There are Serbians in Joburg shooting each other.
Die skietdood van advokaat Piet Mihalik het volgens berigte die Kaapse onderwêreld in rep en roer. Daar word selfdreigemente rondgeslinger oor weerwraakaanvalle. Wiener sê, dit is nie net taxibase en klub-eienaars wat by georganiseerde misdaad betrek word nie.
There's definitely complicity on a very deep level between organized crime and very senior police officers and politicians. And we see that happening repeatedly, where there are allegations of corruption leveled against police generals who are involved in organized crime, who generally deny that this is the case. And then a lot of the kingpins involved in organized crime are often working as police sources or are giving information to the cops. And we've also seen the involvement of politicians on some level as well. We've seen some organized crime kingpins meeting with politicians.
Sy sê ook die stelselmatige aftakeling van die wetstoepassers maak dit moeilik om sulke netwerke te ontbloot.
What we've seen over the past few years has been the evisceration of law enforcement agencies in the country. So from crime intelligence to the Hawks to SARS, we've seen this malicious dismantling of the capabilities to fight organized crime.
Wiener sê, president Cyril Ramaphosa se poging om korrupsie te besweer is 'n goeie begin.
I'm very optimistic actually about what's been happening and the new broom that's sweeping clean. So at the police, for the first time in years, we've got a permanent national police commissioner, a permanent head of crime intelligence and a permanent head of the Hawks, all of which I think are very, very good appointments. At SARS, Tom Moyani is gone. At the NPA, Sean Abrahams is gone. And then at IPED, Robert McBride is there, although his term comes to an end soon. So there have been a number of developments which I'm optimistic about.
Maar, waarsku Wiener, die staatsdiens het kundiges nodig om korrupsie suksesvol aan te vat.
So many good police officers and investigators from SARS and prosecutors have gone into the private sector. They've gone to auditing firms or they've gone to start their own forensic companies. And as a result of that, the capacity has been depleted. So we need to change the culture and get people back into the civil service.